Well, my dear friends, and welcome to Vlogmas Day 3. Yes, we're on Day 3 already, and we seem to have recovered from all our calamities and anxiety, and today we have a special day for you. Moosey is going to decorate the tree, and perhaps if you're lucky, he might burst into song like he did last year. I found my Santas. It started to rain a little bit last night, and I went outside to check on some of my things this morning about 7 o'clock because I wanted to see if Matthew and I did a good job of putting everything back in the shed, and had a few things that I left out, but they were covered. And I've been racking my brain as to where those Santas are. You know how sometimes you know they're somewhere, but you can't quite remember where. I think one of you mentioned that, whether it was Faith or someone else, that her hubby said, yeah, we seem to be saying that. He asked her where something was, hubby did. And she said, you know, I don't know right now, but I know it's somewhere. And we all find ourselves saying that, as hubby said. But I have to tell you that as I was reading the comments this morning from yesterday's video, Doreen, about 10 minutes before I found my Santas outside, and I had put them in a special tub to bring in the house, Doreen told me the story that her gran had a special devotion to Saint Anthony, and she said she had a special prayer that she said. And she said, I'm going to tell it to you now. She took a glass and she put it upside down, and her prayer was this. Saint Anthony, Saint Anthony, please come around. Something is lost and must be found. Amen. And do you know, 10 minutes after Doreen made that comment, I found the Santas in a tub. And by the way, I looked everywhere yesterday and racked my brain last night and this morning. Patricia also, at about that very same time, said a prayer that I would find my Santas, also to Saint Anthony. So all those of you who said a prayer, I thank you so much. You know, he's never let me down before. Sometimes I forget as I'm frantically looking for something, and in desperation, I will say, oh, Saint Anthony, please help me find it. Do you know he found one of my diamonds one time 30 years ago that fell out of my engagement ring? And I found it like 3 days later up at Colleen's house on the floor, a teeny diamond. Can you believe that? Anyway, let me see what else I have to do today. You know, you're all helping me decorate. I have to laugh because there were over 200 comments yesterday all about my decorating and the problems that I was having with my undecorating. Now, as you can see, and I'll take the camera over later and show you up close, I have done a little bit of redecorating yesterday. The problem was that here on this corner where I'm putting my Santas, and I have them right here in the house now. I had put that heavy artificial garland that I had gotten. I think that one's a Big Lots, and it was so heavy to move, I had to take everything down again to sort of pull it over to the right to make room for my Santas here. Oh, teeny. Teeny said that if she saw my candles lit again, and if she saw any real foraged greenery, she was going to have to come over to my house and give me a slap. Well, Teeny, I'm so sorry. I might be hearing you knocking on my door any minute, but I had to put my candles on just because it looks so much prettier. And by the way, I will put them off right after I finish the video. Now, some of you also wanted to see how this candle lighter worked. When I showed you this in the first video, I believe, it's so great. It's an LED chargeable, and I think you pay $12 or $13 for two. She was going to get four, but she wanted to see how it worked. So I have a candle here. I'm going to blow it out, and I'm going to show you how it works. Now you push this little button up and you see some blue lights come on, and then I have to have my glasses on. There's a button, and can you see the end light up? You touch the candle. Whoops. You know what? Here we go again with Nanny. I'm going to take it out of here. I can see. You go in. Look at that. It's lit. You just touch the wick of the candle, and this little thing on the end. Oh, look at that. Isn't that amazing? This little thing on the end. You see it light up right there? It's a wire of some kind that you just touch the wick with. See it light up there by my thumb? And voila. Maybe I'll do it right here. See it light up. These things are wonderful. Get some. They make great gifts. I have to mention some other comments. Joyce said to me that she just loves the reality that we have going between us. She said, I sort of feel like I'm talking outside my kitchen window opposite yours, and we're Blanche and Gracie just checking in every morning. That's so cute. Your comments are so heartwarming, and I just love all these comments. Now, Teenie again gave me the best. You're all helping me to decorate, and I appreciate your help so much. Now, when I get over there and show you up close, I told you yesterday that I needed to raise up the Holy Family because the greenery was hiding most of the little statue. So she said, get some books and put the statue on them, which I did, Teenie. Thank you so much. And also, I raised up the two plates on either side too so that you could see them. So you're all helping, and we're doing great. No snafus today, right? No way.
Not yet.
Uh-oh. Mosey, don't jinx me. Okay, let's get this show started. Here's a little beauty tip. I started this video off with no eyebrows done. And I just did them now because I noticed it. I had no idea it was so noticeable that when you haven't done your eyebrows. Now, I have lost a lot of hairs in the middle, and they look so far apart. And I just did them now, and there's such a difference. Amazing. What I've sent for is one of those eyebrow pens that has the four forks so that when you draw on there, you get more than a pencil. This is really hard. You have to press hard in order to get everything on, especially the tails. But someone once said, and I always remember this, that to get the finished look on your face, you do need a nicely shaped eyebrow, and if you don't have one, you form one. And I'm going to see how these, I like the idea of a natural looking eyebrow with hairs showing. So I'm hopeful that this new eyebrow pen will create that. That's it. A few more comments that I want to make. I think it was Mercy and also Celtic Dollface loved that my pups were bursting into the house looking for their treats from Nanny. And those of you who love your fur babies, you're going to love the little clip that I caught Shamu sleeping under the Christmas tree. Now, what could be more Christmassy than that? And I have a little clip of that. I might have mentioned that Shamu definitely is claustrophobic when he comes in the house, but it's raining outside and you could almost hear him purring 3 feet away. Now, one thing that I do have to mention, one more thing that is still missing. I have a tub of what I called Christmas sweaters. And I know I showed them to you last year when I was putting fall things away and bringing other things out. A day I spent outside going through my yellow tubs. And I remember Colleen in the big purge day making a sign saying Christmas sweaters. And I don't know whether they're back in there and have to be pulled out or what. But as a retired teacher, you know how children, well, maybe you don't, but the children that you teach in school, all children love Christmas sweaters. Now, I know there's a lot of talk about ugly Christmas sweaters and people make their sweaters more ugly than they really are and go to parties and there's prizes for who can show up in the ugliest Christmas sweater. Well, I don't buy that. I always loved my Christmas sweaters. And many of my Christmas sweaters are, yeah, I know you hate to hear this, they go back 30, 40 years. And I used to get a new one every year. And I have a nice collection. I might have shown them to you last year. But I do want to wear a different sweater every day. And they're still missing. So ladies, get those prayers going to St. Anthony again. I'm not going out and hunting today. It's rainy. But I'll try and get out there tomorrow to find all my Christmas sweaters. And they're pretty. They're not ugly.
You have to admit it does look pretty when the candles are lit. And I'm watching very, very carefully. You can see my beautiful 12 Days of Christmas. Looks so pretty. And look at the Holy Family. Now, you can't see the books underneath. They're my very precious old books, by the way. I have some old 1800s collection of what I call tiny books. Funny that they're called teeny books, too. So there's the Holy Family looking much better, and the plates are higher. And as you can see, I have moved the greenery around. I said I was going to go out and get some more foraged greens. There's one of our antique clocks that I love. I said I was going to go out and get some more greens from my cedar and cypress trees, but you know what? I don't think we need it. See, now I have to, in defense of my candlelight, they do give the brass, those vintage brass candlesticks and the vintage plates a glow, don't they, in a way?
Well, I've just opened up some of the packages and I'm going to show you some of my Santas now. Now they have, some of them have dates on them. Now these are not the dates that they were made or that I got them, but I think they're indicative of the type of Santa that was popular at the time. Now this particular one says 1910. Now I know there's a Father Christmas on here, which is the Santa from probably England and the Scandinavian countries. Always loved him. I've had these for years. I have a couple of duplicates, and I think I still have a bag missing somewhere. 1890, what does he resemble? Probably he's more like the Father Christmas. And is more of a modern day Santa, but yet he does say something like 1910 or something on there. He's more of our American Santa. And a couple of others. But anyway, I'm gonna put them all up and some of my dupes, and maybe I'll still be able to find some of the ones that are missing. So I'm gonna do that now and then take a little rest, and Moosey will be ready to decorate the tree. This poor fella has a hole in his head. Maybe the other one, I think I have a dupe of him. It would be nicer if I had all of them, but c'est la vie. Now for the tree, Moosey. Are you ready?
I'm ready. I've had my eggnogs.
Okie doke. So here's the tree, all lit up. I put another 200 lights on there, and I didn't blow any more fuses. So in a few minutes, you'll see Moosey coming and decorating the tree.
There we go. You know, a lot of people decorate the tree drunk, but I'm not, so not to worry. If I start singing, that doesn't mean I'm drunk either. Deck the halls with boughs of holly, fa la 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 la, fa la la la. 'Tis the season to be jolly, fa la 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 la. Don't know the rest of the words,
fa la 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 la.
Just remember these three words,
fa la 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 la.
I dropped one down here. Could you pick up that one for me?
Yeah, there's three or four down there. I'll got you back. Just a minute.
I do have a very beautiful something. I'm not even going to tell you what it is to show you tomorrow in tomorrow's video. And it's a beautiful something that Moosey gave me for my birthday. It came a little late. There was a snafu with the shipping. But it's gorgeous. And I highly recommend that any girl or woman on your list might love one of these, but I'll show that to you tomorrow.
Now you might say, why are they all red? Tell them, Moose.
Because I just happen to like red ornaments.
And and in the daytime when the regular lights are on, they show up more. Now we do have so many other ornaments.
How about these gold puppies? You want to put some of them in?
Yeah, let's try those.
All right.
Okay, I've got some hooks. But I'm at the point where I'd love to drag out a few of the old ones. Maybe in a future video, we'll drag out some old ones.
Okay.
Look at that nice big barrel. Let me get some hooks for you.
Something else that I wanted to tell you that will be in a future video, and it might be within the next couple of days. My youngest daughter, Colleen, I think you've met Colleen. She is the gal that lives right here on our property with her hubby, Micah, and the three kids. And Colleen, who was a teacher and earned her teaching degree in college, eventually got her master's and has passed a couple of the exams. There's still one more to go, but has been working, I think it's 3 years, because Shannon was just starting eighth grade, and Shannon is a junior in high school, when she started working for a local doctor, and she is a mental health therapist. And she does a lot, of course, COVID entered, and she does a lot of most of her clients are by Zoom now. That is becoming very, very popular. And she is fabulous. She keeps getting newer clients. She works for a wonderful doctor who adores her. And she does go down to the office every day for a certain amount of time, I think a couple of hours. But as I say, most of her clients are done during certain hours. A lot of them are young adults, but she does have older women. I don't know whether she has any men, but she is wonderful. And she has promised to come on and spend a whole video with us talking about mental health issues. She's a mental health therapist. You will love her, and I'm sure you will enjoy this particular video. I don't know exactly, because she's going to fit it into her schedule. And also, I think at the end of next week, Brendan comes home again. Keep looking for Colleen. We'll do a whole video with a visit with Colleen.
Oh, this is not sparkly, but this is important. Ich liebe dich. You know that what that means, right? I love you. Ich liebe dich.
German.
Huh?
German, right?
Yeah, German. And that was what was inscribed inside your wedding ring. When we were married, you had a ring that said "Ich liebe dich."
And that was our first dance at our wedding reception. We danced to the song "Ich liebe dich." Yes, don't you remember that? We found the music.
I remember a lot of things, but that's not one of them.
Yep. Yep.
All right, let me hang it up here.
You used to sing that to me before we were married.
I love thee more than any earthly creature. I love thee, dear. I love thee, dear. I love thee now and for eternity.
Aww. Our supper tonight, a bunch of lovely asparagus. I like the thin kind. It was only $2.99 a pound. And some yams. Now, you know, I never know whether they're yams or sweet potatoes. But these are the yellow potatoes, which I think are probably, well, sweet potatoes. But that's it. No meat, and it's one of our favorite suppers. Sometimes we have it with string beans, and I like it with broccoli. You know, my mom always told me that you break the asparagus where it naturally breaks, and you know what? It works every time. You always get the tender parts, and the other parts we don't eat. Does everyone do this the same way? Well, it's the end of the day, the end of Vlogmas number 3. Thank you so much for watching and enjoying. I am just loving your comments. You're helping me to do my decorating. You're helping me with my Vlogmas, with ideas. And tomorrow, I think we're probably going to have a meal. I think I'm going to make my chili. Moose has requested chili tomorrow, so I will make it with you. I'll make it in the late morning. And I'm also going to show you a few gift ideas, especially one very special one. What else are we going to do tomorrow? Oh, I'm going to show you my Advent wreath and tell you a little bit something about that. So we still have more to go. You guys, get your prayers going to St. Anthony so I can find my Christmas sweaters. I'm running out of red. I love you all. Thanks so, so much for all your support. Don't forget to subscribe, those of you who haven't yet. Goodbye for now. See you tomorrow, and God bless us all.